And welcome to Let's Play Drizzlepath Genie. Blind, meaning I haven't played it before. Look, there's a dragon. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and this is the second in the Drizzlepath series of four games, at least so far. Written, created, programmed by Tonguc Bodur, Tonguc? I don't know, Mr. Bodur, which I'm saying that right either. I got more games, but this will just load a browser, so I'm not going to do that. Settings. Here are my settings. This is another narrative adventure, a quote-unquote walking simulator, as some might call it. Anti-aliasing can only go up to medium. Unlike the first Drizzlepath game, this is a lot longer, a few hours long, from what I understand, and there are some interactive elements introduced. So I'm pretty sure this is his second game. After this, he branched out to other games, but interspliced within two more Drizzlepath games, which I'll most probably be checking out as well. So, yeah, motion blur, V-sync. I left most of this stuff the same, like default. This, I don't know. It said decreasing the adjustments before starting a new game is not recommended. I don't know why, so I decreased it anyway, because the master volume was up to 100, I believe, and the voice was up to 100, way too high to hear me over it, so that would not have worked. Mouse sensitivity I dropped down, I believe it was at 50, and then you can't change the key bindings. Put subtitles on for English, head bob off. I might mess with that. Unless I forget. Using keyboard and mouse. Obviously, you can see me moving this cursor around. A funny thing here is a movement. WASD. Right? Which I use the arrow. So it says up arrow, down arrow. But what about the A and S being left and right? It doesn't say. So kind of curious if that, or if you can only use AS to go left and right. That's pretty awesome. Okay, so toggle auto move forward. Don't want to do that, so jumping is space, crouch C, pretty standard. Zoom out. Right click. Let's zoom in, just zoom out. Interact is E. Gothic vision is G. That's pretty interesting. And toggle sprint, yeah. So, new game, the last save was like nothing, it was just me watching the intro and like changing the sensitivity of the mouse and stuff like that, because it was way too high. But so, not really anything of any importance, this save, so we're gonna do new game.
Once upon a time. Isn't that how stories are supposed to begin? That is how my mother always began her stories. But why can't they end that way? Because the ending is usually when the promise of everlasting happiness is proclaimed. What are stories if not the memories of our people? And if memory is any clue, there is no guarantee of happiness. Is it just a myth that there is any such thing as happily ever after? Memory is a broken mirror, fragments of reflective glass and fractures of light, gleaming in brilliance for a moment before fading forever into vague washes of soft color and deepening shade. Sometimes, the harder we try to focus on them, the more they fade and slip from our grasp, beautiful shards that, when taken all together, make us who we are. Memories or dreams. Sometimes it is impossible to tell the difference.
Now that sounds like a big problem, not being able to tell your memories from your dreams. I'm not sure what to think of that. Alright, we got this. And I'm pressing E. Yeah, nothing. Yeah, man, you can't remap the keys. I mean, most of them... Okay, let me just see. Okay. Left and right arrow do the same as A and D for the WASD.
Last night in my dreams, a mysterious wizard came to me. He spoke in a foreign voice, a series of strange sounds that formed a single word. In that word was a message that I understood. He said that I had been chosen, and at the same time, cursed. Lula, he said, because of your gifts of both endurance and vision, you have been chosen to retrieve the sacred relic of your people, the Genie.
Yes, retrieve the sacred cabbage. It is most holy. Well, I guess we're going this way. Well, those are some spooky looking trees over there. I'm not sure I'm going to be messing with those. We saw a dragon before. I just wanted to make sure that was not a dragon shadow. Here it is, the path, the Drizzlepath. It's more like a heavy rain path right now. I could use an umbrella out here. There's a little jankiness with moving. I don't know if that's just... if that's a frame rate issue, or if it's just that's the way it goes.
But another wizard, who wants the genie for himself, has cursed you with the inability to run.
Oh, crap.
Even now he makes his way to the top of the mountain to claim it as his own. You must reach the genie before him and learn its purpose, its power. For if he takes possession of it, you will be further cursed with the inability to walk. You and your people will never again be free to choose your own path.
Who are my people? So I can't run, but this genie's... How am I going to beat this genie to the top of the mountain?
So make haste, child. Do not tarry.
Child?
Though the path is long, it is the shortest. Though the path is not easy,
oh,
it is simple. Though you walk alone, fear not. I will be with you.
That's the wizard talking.
But you will soon have an important choice that only you can make. And that choice will make all the difference. Thus, I woke to a morning of light drizzle, and under the soft light of early dawn, began to walk towards the Mountain of Fire.
This is a soft drizzle, and again, we've got the Mountain of Fire, same as in the first game. I really did like that one graphic, I just want to say, with the girl and the wizard, I guess, appearing. Just looked like a form of a man. Pretty cool, nice artwork, I liked it. I like this music.
Life in the village has fallen out of balance since the genie disappeared. Before then, we had the freedom to choose our own paths in life. But now they are decreed by the shamans when we come of age. There are hunters and fishers, collectors and keepers, weavers and walkers. Only one path has ever been chosen for each person, until me. The shamans decreed that I am both weaver and walker.
Lucky you. You get to be both? Oh, awesome. There's something like this in the Outer Worlds, like a kind of bridge, a stone bridge. Of sorts. Actually, it kind of looks like a window into another land, doesn't it? Oh! Again! Like the first Drizzlepath, you kind of quickly...
Weavers do not just weave fish baskets and blankets. They are also weavers of words. Poets and storytellers. They keep the history of our people and weave their words into the warp and woof of every textile.
There's jumping.
Walkers are the wanderers and wanderers, the dreamers and askers of questions. They are the seekers of whatever light they may find to illuminate the darkest corners of hearts and minds. Of all that have walked away from the village, none have returned.
We... Yeah, you got that speed up part, and then we slow down. So there's jumping, there's crouching, sneaking. There's running, which is left shift. But I guess we're already running. And what else was a gothic vision? Oh, okay. Just a black and white. So gothic vision is black and white. You know, I've seen Gone with the Wind before, and I never thought that was such a gothic movie. Oh, what's that? Look at that. Shimmering thingies. Look at that. You can see it better if you go like this. Sorry, guys. Probably driving you insane. Yeah, we've definitely got some kind of flying insects. Incandescently lit. Oh, maybe they're not insects after all. Ooh. So, and then here we've got the mist. The doom. The doom glade. Oh, and here we've got, they're triangles, that's interesting. Wait. So which way do we go? Are these triangles too? We've got a fork in the path. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Catch a tiger by the toe. Alright, let's go this way. Towards the red stuff. This place is... So how's that mist, or is this supposed to be on fire? Well, we are going to the mountain of fire, right? So this might be the right way. It doesn't look like smoke. It looks like mist, like fog. Yeah. Cool. We can't, like, get up towards trees. These trees have force fields around them. It's some kind of, like, conservation effort. Can you imagine that? You could put force fields around trees. The lumberjack would come up with his axe and... or his, chainsaw and... Q. What was that again? Q. Q is toggle auto move forward. Well, I don't want to turn on auto move forward. Maybe it's just giving us a hint that we can use it. Hope it's not something that's required. Q. Okay. So now I'm not touching anything. I'd rather touch things though, so I turn it off. I mean, I know I'm just pressing forward button. But it makes me feel like I'm more in control. I'm not like so much on rails, even though I am. Well, we haven't heard any music or narrator for a while. I've been deserted. Did
this
I take?
Left path feels right.
Okay, I was just about ready to say that I go the wrong way, but now the left path feels right. Okay, good. Good to know. Does the left path have any music? I'm kind of missing that right about now. I want to, like, look around, but I'm thinking there's really nothing there and I can't get back to the path. But quick. Hold on, let me just look over this ridge. Because I hear water. Do you guys hear water? Or something? I hear water, I just don't see water. Alright, let's go back to the path. Jumping into action. It just sounds like water swishing. Is it supposed to be? Well, that's thunder. I mean, maybe that's supposed to be wind or something, but it sounded like water. Yeah, with these spooky trees. Their gnarled limbs reach out to me. Well, there's nothing here. Oh, that is very sparkly. Look, very sparkly, very twinkly. Whoa. I almost smashed my brains against that rock. Very quiet. So I suppose by the end of this we'll have pneumonia. Or hypothermia, I don't know how cold or warm it is out here. I wonder what's up with all the dead trees. There was a fire here some time ago and the trees have not returned to life. I mean, some of them might be new. And these are the old burned out trees. Whoa. Okay.
The stars came down like tears from the night, as if the sky itself were racked by her sorrows, seized in the rictus of the dead, their coronal pallor, lily cold, white as whales, convalescing 10,000 feet too deep. Is it horror or beauty they feel? Or are they the same things? Or is it simply the end of feeling, perhaps mercifully, perhaps tragically?
I really don't know. I cannot answer that question. But I'm a little spooked out right about now. Well, look how fast the clouds are moving. Good God, man.
I had seen death and wondered what it was. I have been there to hold the dying when the shamans pressed a finger to their mouths and whispered them away. We each imagine something different for them, whatever soothes the heart, but I fear that death is nothing. How can we know? It seems impossible to imagine the end of imagination, to think of the end of thought. The answer to the mystery of death may be in the answer to the mystery of life.
Maybe. Imagining the end of imagination, she says. Certainly very spooky indeed. I cannot read that. That is not in a language I recognize. Or even an alphabet I recognize. Oh boy. I've got actual crypts just sitting here. Yeah, that's not English. Okay. What's the most monumental thing we've seen since this started? Actual, like, structures of... Oh, boy. Wow. Half expecting this thing to, like, come to life, raise that sword, and chop me down. Oh. Something broke out of its crypt. I don't want to be here anymore. Well, at least that one's intact. I can't approach it, though, because of the force field around the tree. More runic graves. Well, this guy's facing this way. What? I heard something. I heard something, like a voice. Was I imagining it? Oh, there's red stuff over there. Are we headed that way? We might be headed that way eventually. Or maybe not. Oh, let's go over there. These are like the same red things we saw at the beginning of this path. Yeah, the music is driving me insane. Oh. So I wonder what the significance is why these red things hang out over here. That's a dead end, alright. Does that mean danger or something? Did I choose a difficult path? I mean, I thought it was just walking. This one holds the sword up over its head. Oh, okay. Force fields. Wow. Unmarked graves. Well, they're marked, they just don't say. They're not marked with a name. At least the walking is kind of quick. Some of them were.
Then the universe held its breath, as if the gods themselves were waiting for a sign. A sign in their long slumber to wake them from dream. The shamans say that the gods fell asleep long ago, before the time of people, when there was nothing but stars in the darkness. In their sleep, they dream the world and us into being. It's a pretty myth, but I wonder if it's true. And if so, what happens when they wake?
Can I not find that out? I'd be happy enough just not finding out what happens when things wake around here. I don't know if it's worth it to go and investigate every one of these. I mean, it doesn't look like you can go in any of them. Or go on them. I thought the door was like caved in on that one.
As I walk, I wonder what I will find at the top of the mountain of fire.
Fire.
I have only heard of the genie in stories and have never seen it myself. I feel awe, and with it, more than a little fear. Can there be reverence without fear? Awe without mystery? We seek answers but resist them when they threaten the notions we feel. Often we prefer to dwell in the dreams of the heart than in the truth of the mind. The genie has power. This much I know.
So, what power do we have? We're just a person, right? Now, the thing is, save and apply settings. Save and quit. This stays the same. Save and apply settings. So you can't. Well, this is saving the settings, right? Not saving the game, I'm guessing. Because what if something happens? What if one of these undead things run out and kill me?
I would definitely choose the right path if I had another chance.
Thanks for letting me know now that I'm like almost a half hour down this thing. Oh, like 20 minutes or something, but still.
I remember my mother. Though I was only a girl of 8 when she walked away from the village and me forever. I remember that day and have dreamed it many times since.
Well, that's horrible.
When she came of age, the shamans had decreed that she was a walker.
A walker?
But this brought her great sorrow, because she was certain she was a weaver. She felt cursed. She longed for the return of the genie so she could decide her own path.
I just put the cue, the auto walk on for a second so I could take a drink. So it reminds me of Enderal, the Enderal Forgotten Stories. Your path is assigned to you, but not all people agree with what their path is. Which can sometimes be bad, because sometimes you need someone of a certain path, like you need a medic, and the person decides, well, they're not. I don't want to be a medic, I want to be a farmer. And then someone needs to be healed and they die because there's no medic available. Because it would have been you, but you decided you want to grow corn. So, reminds me of that. You might not agree with your path, even though it's technically what you might be best at. Just because you're good at something doesn't mean you enjoy it.
The day she left was a cold and rainy autumn day, before the tall grasses had been harvested. I saw her in her sky-blue summer dress, long hair, black as the night, wade far out into the field and then stop. She gazed upwards into the sky as the wind made her distant figure look like a broken patch of summer sky, fallen to the ground and battered by the breeze. She clutched herself with her arms, and I felt her sadness. I ran to her as fast as I could.
Well, that's sad. Why? That's why she left the village? You don't leave your own daughter when she's 8 years old. Kids don't just get over that, you know? That's like kind of like the prelude to their whole life is built on those years. Still not liking the music here, it's just getting a little unnerving. I'm missing the acoustic guitar from the first game. Well, we're definitely getting higher up into a mountain here. Gothic vision.
When I finally got to her side, I stopped and reached to take her hand. She felt my touch and pulled away, looking down at me with those pale gray eyes. Even washed in rain, I could tell she was crying. Her eyes seemed to look through me. What if it rained only once in a lifetime, and you missed it? She asked. Of me or anyone, I couldn't tell. She turned her gaze to the distant horizon and whispered, "What is life, if not the longest goodbye?" And she walked away.
Life is the longest goodbye. We. So there's a broken bridge there. Similar to the other one, but yeah. Broken. Oh, here's more of the red triangles.
I close my eyes and see her hurling crumpled papers against candlelit walls, a stranger in her own body. I see her weeping somewhere in the dark corners of our cottage. It pains my father, but she couldn't heal his wounds. She was gone. He woke, the dust still moist with her tears. How she wept and everything in my world was shattered. I hear her and feel like painting. Instead, I run. I run through the rain until it feels like pieces of glass on my skin. I run to the shoreline and fall among the ruins, where the sand meets the water, meets the sky.
Why would you hear her voice and feel like painting? Ugh. I like actually prefer the silence to this, believe it or not. I'd rather just hear the rain pattering serenely around. You know, we haven't seen any animals like in the first one. The first one had chickens, and then frogs, and then there was a turtle. Nothing like that here. Maybe on the other path we'd see something like that. Maybe I chose the death path and the blue is the light path. Or life path.
Because she speaks sometimes when she sleeps, in time. entire worlds in strange articulations that sound out the heart in more uncommon clarity than my most awkwardly acrobatic didactics. Because she sleeps, sometimes when she dreams, entire worlds with certain gesticulations, her hands seemingly demonstrating a moth stricken by her charmingly unconventional inventions. Because she dreams, sometimes when she speaks, entire worlds unintentionally expressing in one simple sound why anyone, anywhere, ever.
Okay.